I've been dreaming on in my head like I've seen it. A life worth living is a life with meaning. I'll do what I love till my heart stops beating. I'm feeding this demon. Got a taste, can't erase bitterness in my face. Work a job every day till your dreams fade away. Like a card, never change, play the game that we say. I need a break.
Good morning, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. What's being described as the largest earthquake, the people there in Elgin, South Carolina, since last December, occurred last night at about 1:31 a.m. local time. So far, 3,029 people reportedly said they felt it to USGS. USGS gave it an intensity level of 5, which means it was felt by most people. Some people had breakage of dishes and windows, cracks in their plaster. Tall objects might have fallen over. It was felt as far as Atlanta, Georgia. Let's see, over here by Myrtle Beach, Long Bay, Jackson, Mississippi, Lexington, Kentucky. Looks like Louisville, Kentucky. Youngstown, Ohio, Pennsylvania. I mean, wow. Okay, we got Massachusetts, New York, almost all the way up to the Canadian border. It's like, wow. Washington, D.C., Maryland. And let's bring it down some more. I wouldn't be surprised if they didn't feel it there in Florida. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of the 3.4, close to where there was a 3.3 this year on May 9th. That one, too, was very shallow. So last night's earthquake was about 2 miles in depth, and everything's measured from sea level. So let's bring it out. What's going on here is we got the movement of the Atlantic growing, the Atlantic plate, slamming into the North American plate. This was a thrust earthquake, which means that the one side of the fault stayed stationary and the other side rose up. On EMSC, here's some of the reports that were sent in to them. It says the biggest earthquake we felt since last December. About 2 seconds of shaking and loud noise, 1:30 or 1:30 a.m. hours, Eastern Standard Time, Sunday, June 26, 2022. Another report says it woke them up. These earthquakes always happen around the same time. Another report from Elgin says, we live in Elgin and it woke us up. Scary. Another report says the entire house was shaking. Columbia, South Carolina, Lake Carolina. Another report from Elgin. Shaking, loud, quick boom, vibration. The quake was much larger than the 3.2 felt, much stronger than the 3.5 a few weeks ago. Felt like a 4.5. Well, we'll have to see if they downgraded it. Another one, Blythewood, woke me up from a sound sleep, felt like the whole house shook, jump, and shook. Loud rumbling before the peak of shaking. Largest earthquake I've ever experienced in Columbia. This one seemed to be stronger and longer than the others. Yeah, they seem to be growing in size, don't they? Columbia, South Carolina. Another one says upstairs and everything shook. Even the handles on my furniture drawers were loud and shaking. Another report from Columbia says, rolling, shaking of house. Blythewood woke two of us up. Worst ever in South Carolina. Could hear the earthquake before we felt it. Biggest one I've ever felt in Columbia. Yeah, what's going on? Well, the plates are moving. And tension has built. And eventually that's going to pop and you could have a large earthquake. Another report from Columbia says the first 3 to 4 seconds were so very pronounced. then trailed off for a period of additional 5 to 6 seconds. Oh my goodness. Bed, windows, door frame shook. Could hear the boom. Scared the shit out of me. Lasted about 5 to 6 seconds, I thought. Had my feet firmly on the floor and felt similar to how nearby thunder can shake the ground, yet longer and perhaps more intense. So here's the monitor from Jenkinsville that I downloaded, and it is stronger than what USGS is saying. It comes in as a magnitude 3.6. And we'll look at the spectrogram right there. And yeah, it really shook up. We got an aftershock here. Let's look at the signature. Oh, too small. Make it bigger. 547. Did USGS report the aftershock? Yes, they did. A 1.8, they're saying that is. But I get a 2.3. The next one at 553, excuse me. I'm sorry, you can even see the signature is slightly smaller, but that comes in as a magnitude 2.33. And then we got another one right here. At 845, 846, USGS is saying that's a 1.3. I come up with a 2.22. Yeah, I don't know where they're getting. Yeah, they're really downgrading these aftershocks. And then we got another one here at 1206. You can see I shortened it up probably way too far, but that comes in as 1.35. If I make it where it's probably supposed to be, which would be over here, it would come in as a 1.80. That one is not being reported yet. So prior to these earthquakes, yeah, we had a lot of movement. Let's check out what type of movement this was. Yeah, that's not good. That's volcanic. I really would have expected tectonic in nature. Yeah, now this one is tectonic. See, it's got the sharper little points on it. Yeah. I haven't marked these smaller earthquakes out on Google Earth, but here you can see they got four of them marked right here. So did you feel any of these earthquakes? If so, please put that information down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. You know, this area does have a history of large earthquakes, as you guys know. I hope you're prepared. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.